Food first or video? Food first. Oh, let's just do the video. In this video, we are going to take a sneaky peek into my weird life when we travel down the gastric canal and understand all about me and food. My name's Inwils, and welcome to the In Crowd. Hello and welcome once again to another personal video, and I'm going to be focusing on a series of blog posts that I wrote some time ago called My Weird Life. If you're coming back for some anxiety and me videos, then don't worry, there's more coming, but I thought it would be interesting to get a global view of my life and see how my life is not only about anxiety but how it impacts and influences the rest of my life. As always, if you have enjoyed this video or any of my videos on my channel, then please consider liking, commenting, and subscribing. And if you would like to give a little extra support, then the link to my Patreon account is down below. Okay, so this is the second time of recording this. The first time I just waffled on for about half an hour and got to the end and thought, this has no structure at all. So I've been away, I've eaten some food, I've got a cup of coffee, and I've written a sort of script to keep me on track. Okay then, so let's talk about my weird life and food and how it sort of like connects up. So when my anxiety first started, I had a whole load of tests done to see whether or not there was anything medically wrong with me. Now, it's been well documented in research that the mind has an impact on your digestive system. You only need to think about when you get butterflies in your tummy, when you're nervous, etc. Okay then, so one of the side effects or one of the symptoms of my anxiety was that I would start to feel sick, as in I wanted to puke or vomit, and then this would get me worried that I was feeling sick and there was nowhere near, and what happens if this happens in public, etc., etc. That would then increase the levels of anxiety, and normally panic would ensue that I would have to get out of the situation or dive out of somewhere or just collapse in the ground. I do remember going through the therapy with my clinical psychologist, and I remember there was one point that he said, so what happens if you do collapse on the ground? Why are you worried about that? And I was saying, yeah, but what about people think? Is there people who leave you and then get you up? You know, they won't be bothered about it. You'll probably be embarrassed about it, but that's it. And I was like, this is a good point. Anyway, let's get back to food. So because of this feeling of nauseous and being feeling sick, I was given a range of tablets to stop me feeling sick. I had some tablets that I have no idea what the name was, but absolutely fantastic. I started to feel sick, popped a tablet, it went away, and then I didn't feel anxious anymore, and it's fine. Absolutely wonderful. They did think that I might have a stomach ulcer or something wrong with the flap of my stomach, so I had to have an endoscope, you know, tube down the throat to check out the stomach and entrance, etc. And there was a lot of inflammation there, but basically everything was fine. And I got to the point that I was just taking these tablets, and I thought, hang on a minute, I need to almost like sort out what's causing this rather than treating the symptoms. I wanted to treat the cause rather than the symptoms. And so I wanted to sort of like unpick, and this is when I was in therapy with my clinical psychologist, try to unpick and how to cope with these feelings and hopefully subdue them in order to progress. Now, it was around this time that I also got a rather nasty gastric bug. And because of this, well, I think is because of this, a condition reared its head afterwards, which seriously restricts what I can eat. So you have to understand that I'm a vegetarian stroke vegan, so I eat no fish, meat, and I don't drink milk. I drink soya milk, and I can eat eggs, and I if they're free ranged, and I can eat cheese as well, but there are vegan cheese, and that's probably a video, a complete video in there why I had my choices, and I'm absolutely happy to share those with you. Anyway, but as well as being that, that restricts what I could eat, and then the anxiety on top of that, and then the anxiety causes this other condition to rear its head. So whenever I get anxious or worried about a thing, I find that my bowel goes into turmoil, and what I suffer from then is IBS, or irritable bowel syndrome. Now you might want to stop the video now if you are eating. Finish eating, then come back later. So what is irritable bowel? Well, this is not a medical description. This is what I sense it at. That my bowel, my large intestines, gets inflamed and it spasms. And because of that, I get really a lot of pain, and the waste products is pushed through quickly, and so the water's not absorbed, and so it the feces becomes very diarrhea. Anyway, enough of that, I'm not going there. So this is set off via me being anxious. So if I'm worried about something, and it's a really strange effect, because I might not actually be worrying about it, but it's almost as if my brain is worrying about it in the background. And then I suddenly get the pains in the stomach, and I think, oh, I know what this is. It's also set off by certain food. So any food that is high in fiber, so things like brown bread, citrus, nuts, beans, anything like that sets it off as well. I've got it here. I actually live off a low fiber diet. Here it is. And you can see it's well used, this. Anyway, so generally, if I'm worried, then it sets off my IBS. Now, sometimes this is really dreadful. So the other week, I was going back to work, and I have a half an hour walk to work. And as I set off, my stomach cramped. I thought, I know I need the bathroom. Came back in the house, the flat. Thought, this is ridiculous, let's go, set off again, came back in, out, and it takes me a while to sort of like think, look, this is psychological, sort yourself out. I try to bypass my brain, try to put some music on or a book on, and then I walk and just think, hell with it, you know, anything could happen. So it's really sort of like, I actually went to the doctors at one point and said to them, look, the pain, the side effects of this are really bad. It's getting to the point that I can't go out, etc., etc. And of course, the anxiety was feeding into this all the time. So they gave me some tablets, well-famous tablets, and buscopan it's called. And I took 8 tablets a day to stop the pain. And I could take something like something called Imodium. Copious amounts of that to sort of like stop the flow, so to speak. And the other thing is that they sent me to a dietitian, hence this, from the teaching hospital, low fiber diet information for patients. And so what I do is that I have to restrict my diet. So as well as being a vegetarian and vegan and slash vegan, I can eat limited stuff, and anxiety sets everything off. So my food habits are really strange. I tend to have to eat at regular times. If I miss that time, I don't eat. So yesterday I tweeted that I had been working hard at work, the time went by, I forgot about it, and then all of a sudden I suddenly realized that I hadn't eaten any food all day. So I try to eat at regular times. I have found certain things that do not inflame my bowel, so I stick to those. And so that becomes a repetitive routine, which is actually bad. It's good for my IBS, but it's bad for my anxiety, because I feel very safe in a routine. And so if I deviate from that routine, then I feel very anxious. And I almost like think I'm going to be ill because I haven't had what I normally have. And, you know, that routine is really important to me, and I'll probably talk about it in another video. I find it very hard going around to other people's houses. I'll have to tell you sometime about my worry about germs and things like that. I tell you, I'm the most complex person you've ever met. So it's hard to go around to other people's for meals. I have a wonderful family that sort of like cope with it. Well, I think they deal with it, that they know that I can't eat certain food. They prepare vegan meals for me. And if I'm really good, I'm quite happy just to pick things off a plate that I can eat. Or I literally say to people, don't worry, I'll just bring my own. And I'll bring my own pack up. So I'm quite happy about that. I do get very anxious if there's not food I can eat, or I'm at somebody else's house, because I feel it's really bad manners not to eat something. So that's really hard. It's almost impossible to eat out. And I don't do well with social situations. I can put on an act to try to deal with them, but given the choice, I wouldn't go into out for a meal or a night out or anything like that. I'm teetotal, I don't drink alcohol at all. And so I feel I don't like going out, and I know I actually use sometimes my veganism or my vegetarianism as an excuse and say, oh, they don't do a meal for me. But really and truly, it's because I don't like going out. You know, I like to be at home by myself, interacting with very few people. And that's almost like like a hermit. Yeah, I would make a really good hermit. So my food is really strange, and it's sort of like all mixed up with my anxiety. And I think the reason I want to tell you this is that sometimes people do not understand how complex anxiety and feeling anxious and mental health in general actually is. And it's not sort of like I just get worried. It has an effect on everything, and it really can have a debilitating effect on things. And, you know, even going to work in the morning, I can feel anxious and not leave the house for several minutes. My bowel gets very painful, so I have to take Buscopan. I might feel sick, I might get really bad reflux, so I have to take Gaviscon. And it's really interesting, because all the time I'm trying to treat the cause, but it's the medication that treats the symptoms that actually reduces it. And yeah, so anxiety and me and food, I have a very weird life with food. Sometimes people make fun of me in the sense that when I'm at work, I have a Warburton thin with a vegan cheese slice and 5 grapes, and it has to be 5 grapes. And looking back on it, I don't know why it has to be 5, and really I should try 6, but it's just that routine, and that's it. And that's a very safe routine for me. So I'm struggling to think how I'm going to finish this video. So I think I'm just going to do it like that. That's me and food, from my mouth down to the other end. I hope it's given you a bit of insight into me. And I hope that talking about it and sticking it out in video, if you're watching this and thinking, that's me, that's me, then, you know, keep going, because it's only when we challenge it and try to fight it and try to overcome it, then we actually make steps forward. And just to be reassured that although I do say it's my weird life, we're probably not weird at all. We're probably just being ourselves, and it's just something that we have to cope and endure, I think is the best way. So, as ever, if you have enjoyed this video, then please do consider liking, comment and subscribing. I'm well on the way to 500. I've got 466 subscribers, so you know I'm on there. The channel is growing, it's little by little, and it's all down to people like you. So thank you very much, and until next time, please remember to be yourself and say what you think, and remember that the people who mind don't matter, and the people who matter don't mind. Have fun, and I will catch you all later. And until then, happy staying positive. See you all later. Bye.